Yo, what is up, guys? Before the video starts, make sure to like and subscribe. Yeah, so anyways, now I'm going to be telling you why, in my opinion, Skye isn't good for low elo players or even mid elo players. Like, I would only recommend playing her once you get to diamond. Now, of course, this doesn't apply if you play in like a consistent 5 stack and you have like strategies and stuff. Like, if you have like agent masteries and like strategies and like executes and all that, do whatever you want. But I mean this more for like solo queue or even duo or trio queue or whatever. Hey, first off, I'm going to talk about her bird. Now, her bird, I mean, the flash duration is pretty good. Like, the specs of the flash is good. But the thing about it is that it could be easily destroyed. But the trade, like, the good thing about it is that it gets info, but it's not really much info. Like, it only tells if someone got blinded by it. So it's not really that, like, good for a source of info. And usually, info in lower elos isn't as important as in high elo. Especially, like, info where it's like scarce info. Like, for example, let's say that you were on split and then you were in low elo and you flashed mid. If you didn't flash anybody, you probably wouldn't think it, like, anything about it. But if you were in a higher elo, let's say maybe like diamond or something, then if you flashed mid and if no one got flashed, then you might think, hey, I should push mid because no one is there. And you know, that's like scarce amounts of info isn't really like important in low elo, and it's not going to be helpful. Next off, her dog. Now, her dog leaves her vulnerable and doesn't really like provide much info and can be easily destroyed again. Overall, in like pretty much any elo, it's not really that good because, again, it's so easy to destroy. Like, you could probably even destroy it with a classic pistol pretty easily. And it's extremely nearsighted. In my opinion, they should buff Skye a little bit and have her dog have like much more vision because it's so nearsighted. You have to get like extremely close to be able to actually scout people with it. It's like a Sova owl drone that's like 10 times worse. Next off, her heal. Now, there's nothing bad about her heal. The only really bad thing that I can think about of her heal is that it forces you to group up. Other than that, it's a good heal. It's a good ability. I'm not going to say anything bad about it. Now, finally, her ultimate. Now, her ultimate is really just not a good ultimate. It can be easily destroyed. It gets small amounts of info, which, again, the info that you're going to get with it isn't really that important in low elo. It still gets more info than her bird and her dog, but still really not that much. And it's hard to use. I mean, like, you have to use it in only specific scenarios. And only in specific scenarios are you going to get value with it. Like, even I don't know the specific scenarios to use it in because I'm not a high elo player. Like, you have to really, really be thinking about where everyone's playing and your execute. And basically, her ultimate is just way too hard to use. It almost always gets no value, and it can be easily destroyed. Like, when I see a Skye ultimate, I'm not scared. I could just shoot it out easily. It's not really that scary for me. Okay, and then, yeah, and also, not only that, but in low elo, people like initiators, controllers, sentinels, maybe not controllers, but basically anyone who has like a more passive role isn't really gonna rank up fast because, like, you know, in low elo, you want to be playing like more aggressive type characters, because if you play more aggressive type characters, then you'll be able to get more kills and you'll be able to rank up faster. Again, this does not apply if you're in a 5-stack, and if you're really, really good with sentinels, then I'm not saying pick an aggressive character, but I'm just saying aggressive, like, you would benefit more from playing an aggressive character. And to be honest with you, you will rank up more if you play aggressive characters. That's just the honest truth. I mean, it's not really me hating sentinels or me hating initiators. It's just basically facts. Now, and yeah, and like with most initiators like Sova and Breach, like, you could get pretty aggro with them, but with Skye, you just, like, she's so passive in my opinion. Like, her flashes, like, you have to like drag them out and stuff, so you're not gonna be moving a lot. You can't really be like Breach where you're moving with your flashes out. And then her dog, you literally have to just stay there like a Sova owl drone, except that, like, it doesn't really get that much value. And then, like, again, like, her heal, you have to be near your teammates. You have to play a much passive role. And she's an extremely passive initiator. So anyways, Thank you guys so much for watching. Again, this really doesn't apply if you have a five stack and you've, because like if you have like strats and if you have like agents that are going to complement Skye, then all, by all means go for it, like play Skye. But like if you're two stacking, three stacking, maybe even four stacking, and especially solo queuing, just do not play Skye, just avoid her. Thank you so much for listening and enjoy your day.